Up, bruh.
What's up, guys? How's it going?
So you got first at a Massachusetts tournament, you know? Yeah. Came here, put in that work, showed us what's good. All right, so we were talking earlier about mentality. And you were talking about, like, your trip to Eden kind of, like, formed your new mentality.
Yep.
I hella want to talk about that on commentary.
Okay.
So you were talking a lot about ego and how you felt it affected you. How are you trying to go into this new melee era with you, like, less ego, less about the players, more about yourself?
Okay, so I think that, all right, so it's really hard to convert my thoughts and, like, my experiences into words that other people won't just, like, think is really pretentious, because that's what people like to do, you know? They like to label things and group things into ideas. So saying ego, I always like try to find a different word for it, but it's just like you have this like idea of what you play like, and a lot of people stick to that idea, or like, you know, like for me it was Mango. Like I resonated with Mango, not his ego necessarily, but like his playstyle. And once I saw his playstyle, I was like, oh, that's cool, he does cool things,
yeah,
he does risky things. That's how I want to play. So I studied him and I just played like him. And then I realized that that's not going to, like, trying to be someone else. And like, even if I do resonate with a player, you should still try to figure out what's best for you. And I think what's best for everybody is to find balance in their gameplay. And that's been what I've been trying to do, is just like, not just go for style, never go for style really. Like, style just comes with executing well. Like when you see Hax, he's like, he rarely goes for anything that's inefficient, right? But it's still stylish. Everybody loves Hax's mm-hmm. Fox. Same with his Falcon. When he was playing Falcon, like, people thought he was the most stylish player in the world, but to him everything was efficient, everything was with purpose. And so after tackling and like thinking about this a lot, I realized that everybody plays with an ego. I mean, even all the top players have an idea of how they play, and they conform to that idea as much as possible, even when they practice. And so my goal is to show just the power of how far you can get if you push yourself as much as possible, in terms of keeping all, like, respecting your opponent as much as possible, playing, like, when people say play honest, like, I don't know what they mean, but my idea of what the word means in the context of melee is just like always respecting your opponent and doing things that are safe or 100% with purpose. So that, like, what's an example? Just like going for 50-50 setups instead of, or like going for, not going for guaranteed setups. Like trying to go for something that's not efficient is, like, you're doing yourself a disservice, because you're not pushing your character and yourself to play in a way that maximizes your potential.
So you're talking a little bit how you're respecting your opponent, and then we were talking about how, like, you're respecting your people in pools, you're respecting your, like, first round in the actual pro bracket.
Yep.
Do you think that's more beneficial than thinking, like, oh, this dude, I've never heard of this dude, he's free, I'm gonna body him? So do you think respecting the person is better than just, like, thinking they're a random and think you're going to ruin them?
Yeah, so I think that it's easy to go into a match and underestimate the opponent who you've never heard of, and you're the best player in the region, or, you know, top five or whatever, mm-hmm. and just go your secondary and beat them up and or whatever. But I've done that for so long. Like, I did it for an entire year. I was the best player in New England for an entire year.
Yeah.
And I beat everybody, like, besides Zoso, who was on and off, I beat everybody in my region with, like, my secondary tertiaries and, like, what up to infinite numbers, my Samus, like, you know, and my ego was the source of, like, that. It was from a bad place. Like, what I was thinking, I think, at the time was that I wanted people to catch up to me, or, like, I had no, like, my ego said, you know, like, it's who I was at the time. It was just, like, I'm so good that I can beat these people, or, like, watch what I can do, you know, to the second best player in New England. I can beat him with whatever character. And it was under a different guise, but ultimately that held me back from growing in a way that could have benefited me now, and I realize that now. So the biggest thing is, for my first round like matches and stuff like that, I try to think about how much effort other people have put in the game and treat them with the most respect, because if you've played as many hours of Melee as I have, or any of the top players in the world, then you get a good grasp of like how bad people wanted the passion. And so if you go and style on people with your fourth best character, that's not really like giving them you. They're not really playing you, you know? They're not playing the you that you've been training to be, you know,
it's
the best
honest.
You. Yeah, it's definitely not. It's not honest. Like, it's not coming from a good, genuine place. If it is, though, like, if you're honestly trying to train your secondaries, if you're honestly planning on using them in tournament, then that's something else.
So, kind of switch topics here. We're also talking about how CT feels so separated from New England itself.
Yeah.
So, what do you think, like, we can do better to try and make it feel like more one region? How can we steal you guys from Tri-State and make you come to all of our shit and make us come to you guys' shit too?
So I think I'm one of the only players nowadays that really goes to Tri-State tournaments often.
Okay.
I mean, like, I'll see Arl there. I'll see, like, I'll see Psy there and stuff because they have roots in New York too. But I think the biggest...
TN.
The biggest problem for me, or with the idea of the problem right now, which is... All right, the problem is mostly within myself. It's like... I'll come to a New England tournament and be rooted against, like, also New York. The same thing, the same problem happens in New York. I'll go to New York tournament, and then if I'm playing Smuckers or if I'm playing Mafia here, they're the hometown hero, right? But, like, if I play somebody from who's invading, like Gravy or Smash God, right?
We're then, going fucking then,
yeah.
nuts for you.
Yeah, so how do I feel about that? Like, how do I go, you know, like, from 1 week, from Tuesday to beating... Or to beating Smuckers with the whole crowd against me to, you know, being cheered for the same exact people. I think it's really an internal problem for me right now. It's just like, I shouldn't really care. But I think that if the players who support me really want to actually, like, consider, like, if they really are trying to support me, they should consider, instead of cheering against players, cheer for the other player, you know? And that's fine. Like, when somebody does something sick against me, I acknowledge it. I'm like, yo, that was sick. Like, if somebody outplays me in a situation, like now, I 100% understand why I got outplayed and that it was good. Like, now I understand what I'm doing in the game. Before, I feel like I just relied on my execution and autopiloting way too much. And after Eden, I just realized that that's not going to take me to where I'm capable of being, which is the best player in the world.
So what are the good steps that we can get? Like I thought Makari's idea of the Arcadian at the Hog venue was like a really cool idea. Like making it bounce around states, I thought was a really cool idea.
That would
just
be
like,
sick.
And even stock offering fucking $20 to people coming from New Hampshire for
brilliant
gas.
Idea. Brilliant.
That's like I don't know if that's something that Mass Madness has ever looked into, but like I think that's something that would like extremely benefit the tournament itself. Like.
Yep.
Just any way of connecting the region. Maybe having a tournament like in the middle, like somewhere close that we can like Mass and CT can go to.
Yep.
I don't know where the hell that would be, to be honest.
New York does it. I mean, Nico, you know, like they were doing it and then Zoc did it and it seems to work wonders like on getting people out. Like it's just finding incentive.
Yeah.
And for a lot of people and Mass, I don't really understand. Like, Infinite Numbers and, like, all... When you're that far north, it's, like, a hassle to drive into the middle of Connecticut.
Yeah.
Like, it's rough. But if somebody's offering you $30 for gas for coming to the tournament, it's like, okay, well, at least I don't have to pay for gas, right?
Straight up.
But also pop bonuses. Like, if you want to get the good players there, then what you have to do is pop bonus. Like, no
Remember
one's gonna
the time that Hax came to Hog?
Yeah.
That was nuts.
Yeah, it was nuts. Like, just contacting people, too, really does wonders. Like, Nico Ryubi, I'm sure he's spamming people, like, all the time.
I definitely see him. I definitely get notifications up the fucking ass from him.
He definitely messages me more than any other person, like, period. I can't think of one
But
person.
You think it's beneficial to, like...
Yeah.
Do that type of reach out. Like, hey, do you plan on coming this Saturday?
Reaching out is really good, a really good way to get players to come out. Also, just the locals need to show up. Like, when Ryubi, Smuckers, Crush and everybody showed up. Connecticut had some of the biggest numbers we've ever had show up. Like, not the same old people. You know, the same old people need to come. That's like a guarantee. Like, those people need to come when there's going to be good matches. Like, it's great to watch. Like, you're the best player in your state defend, you know?
And the Hog did a great job of getting tons of mass people, tons of...
all different types,
Was, I tried to go, but everybody in my car fucking bailed out last minute.
That's the strength of Connecticut, too, is that it's in the middle. So if we can get... back in the day it was Hacks. But if we could get Flex, if I can confirm the moon, like, I can get these players to come, 100%. If I can get those people to come, I want to be able to guarantee that New England will come. You know, that we'll get, like, a car from Boston, a car from New Hampshire, a car from Rhode Island, and that they'll come, because that's incentive in itself. The incentive is in having competition. The incentive is having people to practice with before a national. The incentive is growth and, like, playing people you've never played before. And even, like, obviously everyone goes to win, but the biggest thing that everybody, like, the biggest thing that you get from the good players coming is the ability to play with them and learn.
Yeah, and the stream viewers, it's always beneficial.
The stream,
just getting people to know about your region.
I mean, I feel like people just aren't doing enough. Not just the TOs and the streamers, but also the players. Like, I mean, like, I can't lie. Last year, if you count how many times I went to NGP, it was unreal. And I think also Nebulous, too. Like, I spent so much money traveling. But, like, then people stopped traveling. The New York locals stopped going to Nebulous, and NGP stopped having the same numbers. And so, like, as somebody who, like, is incentivized by the money and the players, like, the ability to learn, like, it's almost a must that I understand that people are going to show up.
Like, so as someone who hosts bi-monthlies and locals and shit, how do I get all these people to come to my locals? How do I get, like, the Moon? How do I get J-Flex? How do I get CT? Like, what incentives does a mass local have to put out there for these things to get achieved?
I just said it, basically. All right, so as a local TO, you have to, one, let the people know as soon as you can confirm the person. Or, like, see, that's the thing. You have to either confirm a player so that you can get the attendance, or get the attendance, and that will confirm the player. Because I'm not going to... Because there's so many tournaments. Like, I can go... all right, on Tuesdays, NGP, right?
Mm-hmm. Well, not anymore.
What days?
They're temporarily closed.
All right, so on Tuesdays, they're on Tuesdays. And then there's the Nebulous on Tuesdays, right?
Yeah.
So it's like, whichever one has more numbers, I'm going to put the effort in to go to.
Yeah.
And... if you message me and say, yo, I think, I gauge the interest of the players, and it's looking like we're going to get 60 people, and it's to $10, you know, this is like more for Saturday stuff.
Yeah.
It's $10 singles. The Moon is going to consider traveling 5 hours. It's, you know, like, he's not going to consider traveling 5 hours for a 30-man local that's $5 entry because he's not losing money, but he could just go to Nebulous.
And, yeah, it's closer, it's easier for him. And
right.
It's more beneficial. Well, I feel like this was a pretty dope interview. We talked about Connecticut. We talked about mindset.
Yep.
We love having you out here, dog.
Thanks,
whenever you come out, it's fun. And hopefully when you come out next time, we can have more of our top killers here.
Thanks.
This was kind of a weird tournament.
Yeah, I'm sad I didn't get to see any of the, like, other top five players.
Yeah.
Because that's what I wanted to do, was beat them, you know? Yeah. Like, especially after Eden, especially after this big mindset switch, I wanted to see, like, because controlling and breaking habits, like, controlling your ego and breaking habits is something that you consistently have to do, like, and you need to be pushed, right? You need to be pushed into those corners. And today, I don't think I was pushed as hard as I could have been, you know?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So hopefully I get to play these guys soon. Mass Madness is the easiest for us to travel to because it's on Saturdays, and those days are always off, and also because it's $10 singles.
Yeah.
It like, when you get first place and you make $200, even though there's 40 entrants or 30 entrants, it's like, all right, that was worth going to despite the lack of numbers. And then if, you know, Tyler or Lant gets fifth place and he makes gas money back, that's it helps in any type of way.
Well, I hope you can make it out to the future laugh events. because those are going to be $10 entry.
Where is that?
That's in Boston. It's going to be cool. And then my mom bi-monthly, $10 entry.
Really?
Yeah, for the bi-monthlies.
My mom's on Wednesdays.
Yeah, but then we have the bi-monthlies. I think the next one's the last January Saturday.
Just message me, man. Like, we'll see, do, dog. That's the thing. Like, there's so many events. You look at your event calendar on Facebook now, yeah. And it's like...
Even the fucking New England Melee one's, like, so...
There are events everywhere. Like there are... There's also, I think, Wednesday events in Connecticut.
Yeah.
But, like, you know, if you guys are doing $10 entry that day or whatever, or if you guys have...
the locals are five. It's the bi-monthlies are always 10.
Yeah, just let me know.
Yeah, we'll do, dog.
All right, man.
See
ya.
Peace out, dog.
See you, stream.
All right, stream. I'm going to horse some shit out real quick. Mondays, GSS Tewksbury / Multishine Mondays in Rhode Island. Follow Socks on Twitter. Tuesdays, NGP next week only, and then they're finding a new venue, but they don't really know. Wednesdays, my mom, Amesbury, Massachusetts, my tournament. Thursdays, SG, this exact venue, Natick, Massachusetts. And... Fridays have UNH, UML, and Lost in Lancaster, Massachusetts, as well as Saturday being a random tournament every week. All right, stream, follow me, Big L at _SSBM. Peace the fuck out.